Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Mandeep and in today's video we are going to discuss about logistic regression, and in today's video we will be understanding the conceptual part, how actually it works, and in next video we will do the Python coding. So let's get started. So assume that we have given some data, like I have taken few values for age column, and there is one more column is insurance. So let's say for age 22, insurance 0 represents that particular person has not bought any insurance, and 1 means the person has bought the insurance. Fine. So using this data set, if we have to find that if some person will buy insurance or not, then how we can build that model. So very first, if we take this the same data set, and if we try to plot this data set on this scatter plot graph, and let's say this is my age, let's say this is my 20 year, 40 years, this is my 60 years, and this is my 80 years, and let's say this axis represents age, and this axis represents have insurance. That means 0 or 1. 0 represents that person don't have insurance. 1 represent that person have insurance. Using this data, if I try to plot these points, then it would be something like for age 22, person do not have insurance, then it would be, let's say, somewhere here. Let's say here, for 25, again somewhere here. For 47, let's say my 50, and this is let's say my 47, and it says let's say somewhere here, because let's say this represents 1, this represents 0, and for 40 age of 47, that person has insurance, then I have plotted this. And let's say similarly for 52 56, and let's say then we have data point 35. For the age of 35, we do not have insurance. That means 35 would be somewhere here. And 39, for 39 we have insurance, then let's say here. And for 18, we do not have any insurance. For 64, we have insurance, which is somewhere here. And for 27, we do not again have insurance. Which is 27 would be around, let's say, somewhere here, and let's say I put a cross here. And for age 32, we have insurance. For age 32, we have insurance, that would be somewhere here. For 49, we do not have insurance, we have insurance, which is here. And for 50, we do not have insurance. For 50, this is my 50, and this is like. So now assume that this is how my data is scattered, and now if I have to plot a graph using if I use linear regression, y is equal to mx plus b, if you guys want to take a deep look on how linear regression works conceptually and with Python code as well, then you guys can check my previous videos in the same playlist. So if we use this equation here, then let's say linear equation comes out somewhere. I'm just taking an example just to demonstrate it, since it is on a whiteboard, so there might be a little bit of issue with the accuracy. So but that's not the problem. The idea here is to understand the concept. So let's say my linear regression graph line comes something like this way. Now you can see that with this linear regression line, This is not a very good fit line because it is not covering all of the data points, and it is like, so this is, let's say the error is a lot of error is there. So these are the even for error, how error is calculated, you can check my previous video. So we have covered in, so these are my actual data point which I have plotted here, and this is my predicted. So the difference between error and the difference between actual data point and the predicted data point is called as error. How much error is in the prediction. So now you can see, if I take error here, so you can see there are lots of error in this. So this is not the right fit or best fit in this case. So so how we can solve this problem? So where we have like output in case of 0 or 1, or let's say in different classes we want to do some classification, then at that point of time logistic regression is used instead of linear regression, because linear regression is not the right fit for this type of problems, and linear regression will give a lot of errors in your prediction as I shown to you. So how can we solve this problem? So if I take it, so these are the my data points. So if I take a close look on these data points, if somehow I can draw some line, something like this, then this sort of line can cover my all of most of the data points. Obviously there are some outliers always which we can ignore, but if with this sort of line I can cover my most of the data points. So how can we convert this line of linear regression, which is this one, into something of this sort of graph? So this is my linear regression and this is my logistic regression. So that's why I discussed that in such scenarios logistic regression comes to our rescue, which helps us to predict better results rather than linear regression in such type of problem where we have to classify between two classes, let's say yes or no, or maybe multiple classes as well. So so now the idea is like how we can convert this sort of line into this sort of line. So we can convert this sort of line using, there is a function called as, like for linear regression, this is the equation which works behind it, and for logistic regression, so we can convert our this line into something like this, and which can fit into this problem and can give better results. We have behind logistic regression, we have a logit or sigmoid function which works, which is sigmoid function, which is like this one, 1 divided by 1 plus e raised to power minus c or minus z, you can say. So let's say sigmoid of z, is equal to 1 by 1 plus e raised to power minus z, where e is some constant value which is Euler's number, and its value is somewhere around 2.78, something like this. So now you can imagine that what sigmoid function will do, that this line or this line gets converted into this one. So our sigmoid function will do what it will do, it will convert anything into a range of 0 to 1. Like you give any value of z and it will give output between g into a range of 0 to 1, which is our target here. Like in this graph, we basically want to convert our each value into a range of 0 to 1 so that we can predict it in better way. So sigmoid function can do this using this formula 1 divided by 1 plus e raised to power minus e, where e is constant, which is equal to 2.718, something that sort of, and this is Euler's number. So if you take a deep look at this formula as well, so here what we are doing, we are kind of dividing a number which is slightly greater than 1. So here 1 is divided by a number which is slightly greater than 1. So what it will do, it will give us values between 0 to, what it will do, it will convert our numbers between 0 to 1, and then what will happen, let's say if we will put our y is equal to mx plus b into this function, so how it will get converted? So our main target was like how I can convert the straight line equation into something of like S type of curve. So what I can do, I can do this like 1 plus 1 by e raised to power y was my y mx plus b minus of. So what it will do, any value of y which is given here will be converted from into 0 to 1, and ultimately which will turn into a graph of something of like this way, and this way it will give us more better results and more accurate results. So in this type of problems, this is the function, sigmoid function, which works behind the logistic deep look on how. So that's all for now. This is the conceptual part for the logistic regression, and thanks for watching, guys. See you in next video. Thank you.